Hey guys, what's up? It's Danny, and in today's video, I'm gonna be doing a University of Miami Q&A. Everything you want or need to know. What is the best thing about UM? What is the worst thing about UM? Everything about the U will be answered in this video. I just want to say the only reason I'm doing this Q&A right now is because I finally hit 5,000 subscribers, and that is a huge, huge thank you to everybody watching this right now. You guys have no idea how much I grind making these videos. I've been trying to like upload twice a week, but it's finally paying off, guys. Everything, the support, the messages, it really is what keeps me going. Thank you guys so much for 5,000. And if at this point you have no idea who I am, guys, what's up? My name is Danny. I do videos and vlogs revolving around school and lifestyle. Make sure to check out my channel and hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with my weekly uploads. And at this point, if you don't have me on social media, make sure to follow me on Instagram and add me on Snapchat at GoalkeeperDanny. So here's the deal. I promised you guys that I was gonna do a Q&A when I hit 5,000 subscribers. I asked you guys to like ask me questions, anything you guys wanted to know, anything you wanted me to answer. I was insanely overwhelmed by all the questions, which is a really good thing. I'm gonna answer all the questions. However, I'm gonna break it down in two videos. So today is Sunday. This Q&A will specifically be about the University of Miami. Everything you want to know about UM will be answered in this video. And then on Wednesday, I'm going to upload the other part of the Q&A, which is just going to be college questions in general, some questions about me, my life, what do I think about certain things. All right, let's get this Q&A started. All of these questions will be about the University of Miami in one way or another. I will be answering to the best of my abilities. And also keep in mind that all my answers are like because of my experiences, like my opinions as a student. So all the answers can really vary. I'm going to make sure to put the question like right here down below in text. I'm going to say the answer really fast. We have about 30 questions. Let's do this. My favorite place to eat at UM, honestly, the dining hall is like not that bad. I kind of like it. You know, you have like unlimited food and all that, but obviously I'm pretty sure like not everybody likes the dining hall as much as me. So with that being said, my favorite place is Pollo Tropical, or as it should be said, Pollo Tropical. It's pretty much like a Hispanic KFC. They have chicken, rice, beans. That's just what I love. My opinion on the rich kid stereotype at UM. All right, so let's face it, let's be honest. UM, it's a private school. A lot of students do have a lot of money. They're rich kids at UM. Me personally, I'm not affected by it. I'm not a rich kid at UM, and I don't really like worry too much about other people just because I'm trying to do like my own things. So yeah, you know, there's a lot of people with money and all that, but at the end of the day, I'm just trying to like do my own thing. I have my own goals. So I don't really worry too much about other people's money or what they do with it. As long as I'm doing my own thing and I'm happy with what I'm doing, that's all that really matters. Studying at UM, I don't really know if that means like studying for a test or like an exam, or if it means like studying as in like, you know, studying there as like going to college there. So I'll just do both. But like for studying, like for exams or something, you could study outside in the library. There's like a lot of places to study. And then just like studying in general, like as a student, for me, at least, it's been a pretty good experience so far. I like my classes, I like what I'm doing, so it's all cool. Social life at UM. I would say that it's pretty easy to make friends as a freshman, just because like everybody like doesn't know anybody. So it's really easy to go up to somebody and just be like, oh, hey, like what's up, like what's good, like what's cool. But that really, I'm still making like a lot of friends now. I think it's really easy to make friends in college because just like everybody wants to like meet other people. So I think the social life is really like, it's pretty vibrant, I guess, if that makes any sense. It's really easy to make friends. It's really easy to talk to people. And it's also really easy to like not be involved in anything. So really the social life, it varies. You pretty much get to do what you want. Freshman dorm tour. All right, I already did a tour of my dorm last year. I'm gonna leave the link like up there, wherever YouTube puts it. But yeah, I did a video on that last year. Greatest thing about UM. All right, so this is the $1 million question. What is the greatest thing about UM? So pretty much in my experience, or my opinion at least, is that the greatest thing is that there are like a lot of options and they are very flexible with everything just in general, like with clubs, studies. It's like you could really pave your own path like the way you want it. And I know this sounds like kind of cliche because you could do that with pretty much like any college, but UM, I don't know, it just like feels right when you do everything. It's like right now I'm studying athletic training. I also do triathlons. I do YouTube. So it's a good school when it comes to like doing what you want, even though a lot of colleges are like that, but that's just for my opinion. Like, and on top of that, it's also Miami. There's like a lot to do. you're not just like stuck in like a college campus. Like there's just a lot to do, whether it's like academic or socially, and that's something that's really good about it. So now we got the opposite question. What's my biggest regret about going to UMiami? So personally for me, since I'm from Miami, I would say that my regret is that I didn't go to like another city for college, just because, you know, I'm young, I want to explore, I want to meet different people, I want to see different cultures. And by staying in Miami, I really do limit myself to that. So I think that's my biggest regret. I stayed in Miami. I love UMiami. I love my current situation, but I think my biggest regret is that I didn't like expose myself to other things and I just like stayed here. Cost of frats at UM. I don't really know how much the frats cost. I know that like each frat has like a different like figure or number. I do know that like they do have fees and stuff like that, but I don't know the exact figure. So this person said that they got deferred from UM. What should they do to like increase their chances of like getting in? I would say just like look at your application, see like what you did like bad in. Was it like a GPA? Did you have like bad test scores? Did you like lack community service or extracurriculars? And just like try to fix like those things. This person is an international student and they're asking how to get involved in the American culture, how to make American friends. I would say just do it straight off the bat. Don't even think about it. Just do it. Join the culture. Have American friends if you really want to do that. Like I said, it's really easy to make friends in college in general. So if you are an international student, something that honestly is really cool to everybody is that you're like an international student. You're really different. You have a different culture, different background. And if you just open yourself up like that, be like, oh, hey guys, yeah, I'm actually an international student, like from, I don't know, like China, France, whatever. It's like really cool. And people will be like, oh, wow, like you're from there. Like, that's so cool. Like, why did you come to UM? It's pretty easy, you know, just be really open about it. How is UM in general? In my experience, UM has been pretty good in general. I'm enjoying what I'm doing here at the school, so it's been great so far. Was it hard getting into UM? So here's the thing. I don't really know if it was hard or not, but I know that I did work my ass off in high school to get like all A's. So I guess in that sense, yes, you do have to do some effort in high school. But it's funny because I was freaking out, like literally freaking out that I wasn't gonna get accepted. I'm like, oh, I'm not gonna get accepted. My SAT is gonna like ruin my acceptance, because I had all A's, but my SAT was pretty low. But I still got in. So now looking back at it, I'm like, damn, I really should have just like chilled and like not stressed out and worried. Was UM your number one choice? Yes, it was my number one choice. I ED'd, which pretty much meant that if I applied and I got in, I had to go no matter what. And yeah, that's what ended up happening. I got in and I'm here now. Am I excited about Tate Martell coming to Miami? So here's the deal. I support football and all, but I don't really follow it too much. So, I mean, I hope he does like good things for our team, and hopefully we do have like a really good season, because last season was not so good. What do I know about rushing frats at UM? I don't know that much, but I also know a lot. So pretty much, I'll just throw out the basics. If you're a freshman, you can't rush until spring. You have to go to like a lot of events, and then like I think it's like you go to a lot of like networking things. You talk to people from like different frats, and then it's like bid day and they like choose you. And then even during bid day, like it's like you could choose like which frat you want to go to. And even after that, you could still drop a frat, which is pretty much like, oh, I don't want to be here anymore. Those are kind of like the guidelines that I know about, you know, rushing and all that stuff. What other colleges did I apply to besides UM? Let's see if I remember them. Because here's the thing, since I ED'd to UM, I didn't apply to many other schools, just because like I kind of really wanted to go to UM. But I applied to like a lot of Florida schools just because I'm like from here. So I applied to FSU, UF, Florida Gulf Coast, FIU. I applied to three out of states actually. Boston University or Boston College. I think it was BU, Boston University, Connecticut, UConn, that one, and Michigan, UMichigan. So yeah, those were my schools, but I'm at UM right now and that's what matters. The worst thing about UM, all right, so this is kind of heavy. This is like the worst thing about UM in my opinion. I would say it's like the money side of it, and not like people having money or like rich people going to UM. I don't care about that too much. What makes me mad is that it's really expensive at the end of the day. And I know that's just like the way it has to be, but it's just kind of like sad because I know a lot of people that would love to go to UM and they have the grades for it, but they just don't have the money. And even with like scholarships, it's still really expensive. So I don't know, I think it's like kind of sad that like people really want to like go somewhere, but money is like the only thing that's holding them back. And I would say that's like the worst thing of it. Like people that can't afford to go to UM, I would say that's like really unfortunate, but it's just like the way it is. Like I can't do anything about it. I don't think anybody can, but yeah, that's something that I really don't like, how it's like too expensive and some people can't go because it's that expensive. That really makes me sad sometimes. Do I know anything about the medical school at UM? Not really. Like honestly, all I know is that it's like pretty good. It's hard to get into, you know, like any medical school. I would say the biggest key thing is that it's like 20 minutes away from the main campus. It's like near downtown almost, but yeah, that's pretty much all I know. Why do I like Miami? All right, so it's pretty funny because I grew up here. The real reason, like the real answer why I love Miami, there's just like, there's so much to do. Like just so much besides the beach. Like it's a huge city. I'm like Cuban, so it just feels like home. All my friends are like Cuban American. It just has like a special vibe, you know, there's a special vibe here in Miami that like I just don't find anywhere else. And that's honestly something I really like about it. Small stuff too, there's a lot of like small tweaks. It's like on the weekends I go bike riding near the beach. I go to the beach a lot, stuff like that. It's like stuff you just can't do anywhere else. Do I miss living near or on campus? So I actually live in my house, like with my parents, cause I save like a lot of money. And I live like 5-10 minutes away from campus, so it's not that bad. I honestly do not miss dorming. Looking back at it, I have no idea how I did it. I would say it's like really cool dorming just because it's like you meet a lot of different people that part of school, but like the living side of it, like sleeping, showering, all that type of stuff, I have no idea how I did it. Best tea / study spots on campus. So I don't drink any tea or coffee, but I do know some great study spots. Obviously you have the Richter Library. There's a space between Merrick and the business school. It's like this little like path that's really cool. And you have this like outdoor area right under the student center that's really cool. There's like a lot of outdoor places to study. You have gliders right in front of the library. It's also outdoors. There's a lot of places to study. Do I hate Florida State? I don't know. You tell me. Does it look like I like them? Nah, but being legit, Florida State, it's not a bad school. A lot of my friends go there. I might have even ended up going there. It's not a bad school. Obviously, when it comes to sports, it is fun, you know, doing that little rivalry and all, but as a school, it's a pretty good school, I'm not gonna lie. But honestly, at the end of the day, it's all about the U. How is Greek life at UMiami? So for my opinion and like my eyes and all that type of stuff, I would say that like it's there, like there is a Greek life, but it's like, it's like if you don't join a frat or a sorority, it's not the end of the world. I know like people that love frats, people that like hate frats, people that were in frats, people that were in sororities and they like drop them. So it's like a mix. I would say it's like not that big of a deal though, even though like obviously there's still like parties and like other events that go on through them, but it's not that big of a deal compared to like other schools. How is club basketball or club sports in general? Club basketball, actually one of my friends, he's on the club basketball team. I don't know how good they are or like how it works, but I know he's on it. But club sports in general, club sports are like really good. You have like a lot of them and that's what makes it good. You have like a huge variety of club sports. So yeah, that's something that makes UM really good in general. You have like a lot of variety. Can you use dining points at the food court or places nearby? Yes, you can. And they're actually called dining dollars. You could use those at any retail location at the U. What is the area around UM like? So UM is actually in this like city called Coral Gables. Honestly, it's part of Miami, not a big deal. But yeah, Coral Gables is like really nice. It's like middle upper class area type thing. It's really chill. However, once you start going like south, there's a part called like South Miami, and that does have its bad neighborhoods. And also there's some places around Coconut Grove that are like not the nicest, but like on campus though, it's like really safe to walk on, even if it's like really late at night. I've been on campus at like 2 a.m. Around like really close to UM, it's really good. When you start getting a little bit out, it really depends where you are. This student is actually from India and they are planning on going to the U, and they're asking if there's any bullying or discrimination. And honestly, from what I've seen, there really is none of that, just because it's like pretty diverse. So there's like a lot of people. There's actually a lot of like students from India I've noticed are on campus, but there's like a lot of clubs and organizations for international students and even Indian students. Like that's how specifically they get. So honestly, like you'll be fine here. What is UM's rival? Obviously the biggest rivalry we have is with FSU. We also have like smaller rivalries with like UF, Notre Dame, FIU, stuff like that. But the main rivalry is UM versus FSU. Is UM technologically advanced? I would say we're pretty advanced, even with small stuff. Like, we have tables outside, and those tables have like little USB ports to like charge your phone. We're pretty modern with our stuff. Like, in the library, you have like computers everywhere. You even have like a section that's just with Macs. So yeah, we are pretty up to date. Why did you choose UM over any other Florida school? That's a really good question. The main thing that I chose UM for is because they have a major that's really specific, which is athletic training, and that's something that I really wanted to do. A lot of schools don't have that, and UM was a school that had that. And I would say a second reason is that I got a lot of scholarships, and I got like I got a lot of like help financially. So I'm lucky and grateful that I'm able to go to UM, and that just like really helped me out. I had the money to go from a lot of scholarships and help, and they had a really good program that interests me. And that's pretty much why I really chose them over any other school. All right, guys, those were all the questions that you guys had about the University of Miami. Hopefully, I answered everything to the best of my ability and you guys, you know, get something out of this. Remember, on Wednesday, I will be releasing the other Q&A that's just about college in general. I talk about my life, so if you wanna like know me, you have to watch that Q&A. If you guys enjoyed this video or found it useful, remember to give it a thumbs up down below and subscribe to my channel to stay up to date with my weekly uploads. That is pretty much it for me, but always, always remember to stay hydrated.